What's up, everybody? It's Kupo. Welcome to another Risen playthrough. We're going to do a quest today called Open the Great Gate. So we just hit Chapter 3, and this is pretty much the first quest it lines us up with. So let's go ahead and get this started.
You! That gate there!
What about it?
We must open it quickly. We must get inside this place.
And how do we open it?
If a gate can be closed, it can also be opened. I will send out scouts to find the mechanism that opens it. But keep your eyes open too. I suspect there may be more than one mechanism that controls this gate. Go, search to the north.
What do you think this place is?
An ancient fortress. It must belong to the lizards we met at the portal. We must get inside it.
Okay, so we gotta figure out how to open up this gate here. This is probably going to be one of the most frustrating episodes that I do, because there's an area in this that's like near impossible. Okay, so let's deal with these real quick.
Ah!
The strategy is exactly for those. Okay, this part really worries me. I have like a bug problem where when I jump up these things, so I have to save every time because it might bug the game out. Okay, that worked. Did I make it? No, come on. Yeah, I did it. Okay. Maybe I could just literally jump up this one. Sometimes when I jump up, it bugs the game out, so. So here's a hint. There's two Nautiluses here.
Ah!
Maybe I have to transform into a Nautilus to do this part. So let's see, where's the Nautilus scroll? Nautilus scroll, right here. And in we go. Mind me, I'm just a little Nautilus. Okay, and we're in. Do a quick save. I think there's some gulls around here. Took one hit. I'm pretty proud of that. That's not bad. Okay, let's see. What do we have here? I can't really remember. Some more goals over there. Okay. This, I don't think this does anything. Wait, it does. What would that do? I'm not sure what if that did anything. Almost went really good, and then I kind of messed it up at the end there. Okay, let's see what's going on over here. Okay, I gotta jump up here. Which, like I said, scares me because the game's gonna crash. I think I jumped like right here last time. See? The game's crashed. Pretty bad bug. This is something that I think that they should have definitely fixed. So maybe I'll try this one. Let's try to make sure I'm not jumping like through it. Oh, hey, look, guys, the game bugged out again. This is probably my biggest gripe about the whole game is this. Okay, let's try this one. Okay, I can't get up there. It's possible. I did get up in the last playthrough that I just did off of the recording. Maybe if I go like up here. Nope. I tried to look up a solution for this problem, and all I got was you have to go into your graphics card settings and like turn VSync on. And I play a lot of games, so... It did it! Yay! Better save that. What's this do? But yeah, I'm not going to go into my graphics driver and completely change VSync. I absolutely hate VSync. Some people think it makes the game look smoother, but it just makes everything blur when you move the screen. It's just, I don't understand how people don't notice it. Okay, so right here is a trap door. So I'm going to jump over the trap door and then I have to fight a battle. So in fact, I'm going to drink a potion. It might be pretty tough. Quick save, and here we go. Of course, it tries to target the guy in the back. Good for me. Yeah, I don't know what to do about that guy in the back. He just swings at me and I can't. I just have to play the RNG game until I win. How's that for RNG? Up to him and almost one shot him. Okay. Well, I guess we did it. Just gotta get lucky. So I'm gonna potion up again because there's some more battles coming. Does this do anything? I always try to click those rings because I'm never sure. Okay, so there's a trap here, and you can actually jump over it. I thought initially you had to levitate over it, but I guess not. Okay, so I'll do a quick save. Okay, here's frustrating spot number one. These two mobs down here are very frustrating to deal with. What's this button do? Nothing. Okay. Oh, here we go. I don't know if it's them, but in that room, my attack speed's like really slowed. I don't know. He just stood there and stared at me that time. Alrighty, so now we have another, I think, lizardmen fight. Of course, it's gonna change targets. Pretty solid targeting system we got here, fellas. I don't like that the guy in the back attacked me through the guy in front of him. I don't think that's a very good functionality. Makes the game very hard. Basically, you guys just get to hear me complain every time I fight a hard fight, but I warned you at the start that this is probably the most frustrating episode that I'll ever play. Okay, here's the winch. Okay. Okay, this is where we kind of came from. So jump down here, I can talk to the Inquisitor.
I found a winch.
But the gate is still closed. Perhaps there is another. I've sent Rufus to the south. Follow him. Perhaps he needs help.
Okay, so now we're gonna check on this Rufus villain. This is the part that you've all been waiting for. I might throw the mouse, I might throw the keyboard. I'm not an angry person, but this part of the game is just so frustrating. I'm gonna reload that. I don't want to lose all that health to that guy. I don't think there's any actual checkmate strategies in this game, because sometimes they'll hop to the side, sometimes they'll attack multiple times. See, like right there. That could have gone really poorly. It's just all RNG. A big scorpion up here, which was pretty easy to deal with last time. Okay. What is this? Do you see him just forever circling me? I'm redoing that too. That's ridiculous. Apparently, if he's sidestepping, he's invulnerable. You can't hit him. So, See, I didn't even take a hit that time. Okay, saved me a pot. So up there is where I'm about to, you know, throw my keyboard. Stone tablet here, stone plate. Absolutely love to go up here, guys, and see what's up there, but watch this. Game crashed. So I can't get up there. So if anybody knows if there's something up there, it'd be cool to know. I'm kind of disappointed that I can't search for myself because the game doesn't work. Okay, guys, try not to laugh at me too much here, okay? This is gonna be one of the most ridiculous things you guys ever see. In fact, real quick, let me save it. Let me check out this Inferno scroll. Inferno, let's put it on 3. do anything? Is this really gonna work? That Infernal Scroll was pretty cool. This is gonna help a lot, guys. Because you have to levitate over there, and then there's four lizard people. And it's like a 4-on-1 in that tiny little room. I probably spent, like, no joke, a full hour just reloading the game until I killed all of them. So I figured I'd try this, and it seems to be working. Let's save it. This is really what I'm doing. I've got 300 arrows saved up. I'm gonna use them. This is the spot. This is making me so happy that I don't have to levitate over there. Might take a while. If I can get rid of this guy, I should be able to just levitate over and deal with the last guy. Well, there's still two more, but I think you can just pick that one guy off. Oh, that shot missed. Gotta be getting low. Yeah! Saving that. Let's go. Let's go get him. Okay, it's still 2-on-1, but that's okay. He's so annoying. I really need that hit to hit him. Okay. Wow. So that guy had a bust on him right here. We just picked it up off his body. And we're gonna need that bust a little later. The lizard warrior. Executioner staff. He's got an amulet. So that's Rufus. Apparently Rufus is dead, so we're gonna have to go back and give the bad news. Man, I'm so happy that I could just snipe those guys. I think I got lucky too, because the lizard priest guy will actually cast fireballs, so he was like back here. Okay, so let's go ahead and hit this lever, and this will deactivate the trap, which you haven't seen yet, but it's like right here. This right here, you'll die if you stand on this without hitting that lever. go to the right here, and oh wait, we have to break this wall first. So just click.
I could break this down.
I think you actually need a prospecting axe, or pickaxe, whatever you call it. Okay, then there should be Mr. Lizard Man right here. Okay. Then I think this lever will deactivate the rest of the traps. Battle here. That didn't work out. Target the guy on the left, pretty please. Oh no, how'd that happen? Okay. So that guy had the second bust. I just picked off his body. So we got two altars here, we gotta put the bust on. So there's a bust. Here's a bust. Got the winch here, and this should open the gate. Just, I think we just drop on down. And here is Inquisitor Mendoza.
Rufus is dead.
What happened?
Saurians. They must have ambushed him.
There are casualties in war, but we must live if others are not to die.
I found the second winch.
Good. Then use it. Open a path for us. These columns tell the history of this complex. Take a look at them. See what information you can glean from them.
What will happen with the Don and Harbor Town?
What is the fate of one town when the world is at stake? Let the Don take it, I do not care.
All right. So as you can see, the gate is open. So this is a good time to end the episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. Luckily, I didn't throw my mouse or break my keyboard because we found out we can just snipe those mobs. But yeah. Like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you guys in